just get a stand.
Oh, that's good. Happy 6 months to Sarah. Yes, it is officially 6 months and it's 60 degrees outside. I wanted to talk to you about everything I did in 6 months. And guess what? First of all, I have to tell you something really crazy. So I made a video last night or yesterday before work. It was like 15 minutes long. And I really feel like I like said everything I wanted to say. It was great. I went to work, I edited at work, I came home, put it, and my phone said I didn't have enough space, so I had to delete space, which I did. And then I realized once I went back, because I thought it'd be saved in the iMovie, which is what I used to do all my videos. Well, the media was gone. And I had erased my recently deleted, so I couldn't even recover it. So yay me. I had this whole video ready to go, edited, music and everything, and I deleted it. So hi, 6 months to Sarah, still a work in progress. So I started this journey because of a guy that I was seeing and that it didn't work out. And for some reason, that set me on this journey because he had told me to watch some Tony Robbins documentary, and also not just the failed situation. I don't want to call it a relationship. It wasn't that. The failed situation was just where I was with my job, where I was with my finances, where I was, you know, with everything. It just kind of felt like I wasn't going where I wanted to go. I wasn't headed where I wanted to head. So I know I needed to change, and I know me, like I needed something drastic to kind of set the ball rolling or set the wheels in motion. So I said 6 months, I was up one night late and I said, I want to change my whole life in 6 months. All right. And you think 6 months is so long. And then February 2nd was my technical 6 month anniversary of doing this. And I realized how quickly time just goes by. Like, I know it's cliche, but really, like, time is just so precious, and you think you have all the time in the world, and then the years just go and go and go, and you know, you haven't done anything that you wanted to do. And that's a little bit of how I felt with this project. It's like all this time went by and I feel like I didn't do so many things that I wanted to do. You know, my credit is still about the same. I still live in the same apartment. I got a better job, so that's, and I definitely am like happy with where I am right now, and I feel like I'm making pretty decent money. I'm still trying to figure out the budget part of it. But I am very blessed and grateful for what I have, and the job that I have right now is a very nice place to work, and I'm, you know, making consistent money. And as far as relationships, I took a break for about 3 months of dating or talking to anyone. Maybe it was two to 3 months. And in that time, I just kind of set the bar on what I was looking for and really reflected on what I was doing wrong in relationships and how I was kind of setting myself up for failure, and the types that I was going for or attracting was not at all, you know, who I saw myself with long term. So even though I'm still fighting that battle, because I feel like I say men are my drug of choice, I'm fighting that battle every time I meet someone new or every time I meet someone I'm excited about. I fight, you know, these patterns that I fall back into. But I have learned to turn over more quickly, and I have learned to not take it so personal and make it about me and what's wrong with me. And I think that was a big deal for me, is kind of just recognizing that, you know, sometimes somebody's not that into you or things don't work out. It doesn't have anything to do with who you are as a person or what you have to bring to the table. So that was that. As far as cooking and cleaning and all of that, it's a struggle, guys. I'm not gonna lie to you. I work 5 nights a week. I have both kids pretty much full time. And I find it like hard, because sometimes I'm just really tired, but I work on it, and I feel like this is a continuing project. Maybe 6 months to domesticate it, Sarah, for the next one. I don't know. When I was thinking about this, I thought two different paths I could go down and two different perspectives I wanted to share with you. And one path in the 6 month journey is that I completely failed. Get my organization. I didn't start really cooking that much. Like, a lot of the technical things that I wanted to do, I didn't do, and I'm still working on it. So I could say, and you know, I didn't give up dating for 6 months like I said I was going to. So I could say, look, listen guys, I failed. I could say that this project was a complete failure, and that I aimed too high, and I shouldn't have set some kind of a 6 month goal for myself when I knew that I wasn't going to hit it, and that this was just a waste of my time, and that I should have never even made these videos, and I'm a huge disappointment, right? And maybe some of you would take that and say, yeah, like, you failed, Sarah. Like, you didn't do anything you said you were going to do, except for maybe learn how to edit a little bit better, and that's questionable. And make videos once a week, but that's really, you know, all you've done from my point of view. From somebody watching this, they might think that. They might think that, what did you even do with yourself? Just talk and rant for every week? Yeah, that's part of it. But I'm here to tell you today that life is about perspective. Not being so set in stone on what you think you should have accomplished. Like, so for instance, I started this, I wanted to change my whole life in 6 months, and clearly my whole life has not changed in 6 months, but I'm here to tell you, to preach to you, if you will, that even if you change one thing in your life, even if you've changed one habit, even if you've changed one behavior, that is not a failure, that is a success. And so here's the deal, people, I have made a consistent video every week, sometimes twice a week, on my progress, on, you know, and this turns into almost like positive affirmations that I'm speaking out loud, these truths that I want in my life. And I've done that every week consistently for 6 months. This is something that I've said I wanted to do for years. I wanted to make a YouTube channel with a clear purpose. I've always had a problem focusing and picking one thing to focus on, and I did it. I made this project, I continued with it, even when I didn't feel like making a video. Even now, if I don't feel like making a video, I make a video every week, and I speak on things that I feel are my truth, and I try to inspire and encourage through my journeys and through my experiences, and that is a success. So if that is the only thing that came out of this, it is still not a failure, because I did something that I set out to do and I accomplished it. Now, sometimes you set the target like a bullseye, right? If you have a bow and arrow or a gun or whatever weapon, whatever, and you have a bullseye, and maybe you don't hit that bullseye, but maybe you come close to it, or maybe over years or over a few weeks of practice, you get closer and closer to that bullseye. But guess what? If you don't set a target, if you don't have an almost like unrealistic target, you're not even going to hit a little bit of, you're not even going to hit the post. You're not even going to hit the circles around the bullseye, because you have nothing to aim for, because you're just shooting your darts in the air. You're just shooting bullets in the sky with nothing to aim for. So I gave myself a hard target, a really unrealistic target to shoot for, because I knew that if I had that, I would try more than I would normally try just with no target whatsoever. So I'm going to tell you just a couple things that I've learned in this 6 months, and I'm also going to continue these videos. It's still going to be called 6 months of Sarah. It's just going to be a new topic every week. So if you're watching, don't worry, it's not over. If you're not watching, you should start watching, because whatever. Another thing that I learned is to get real about myself and who I am as a person, and you know, face the demons that I didn't want to face, and stop making excuses for the things that I've made excuses for my whole life, and really just kind of sit down and really a lot of self-reflection has gone on in these 6 months. More than anything, I think it's harder to change your brain than it is to change your habits. I mean, you can change your habits, and yes, your brain might follow, but really you have to look inside and see what is triggering you to be a certain way and start to change that. As far as relationships, you know, the biggest thing that I think I've learned through talking to myself every week and through speaking out loud and kind of like listening to podcasts and all this stuff, and is that you have to be a high value person to attract a high value person. I'm going to keep saying this every week, because I kind of thought I was this damsel in distress. I kind of thought that somebody would come along and fix me, save me, heal me, whatever. Even though I said I didn't think that, that's what I exuded. I exuded someone who was a mess, someone who was emotionally, you know, needy, who needed someone to kind of love me so that I could love myself. And it is the exact opposite. You truly have to love yourself, and you truly have to be the needs. You have to meet your own needs before you can let somebody in. That doesn't mean that you're a hard person. That doesn't mean that you aren't feminine, that you don't have your guard down for the right person. But what it means is that you already know your value. So you're not looking for somebody to complete you, to fulfill you 100%, because you know, no matter what, no matter where, what you do in life, no matter who you are as a person, you know that you have value to give, and you're living your life in value. Therefore, somebody else has to either match that or exceed that to be in your life. And if you don't learn that, you're never going to find what you feel like you need. You're just going to find these people that kind of succubuses, that suck all that insecurity out of you and leave you hanging to dry like something's wrong with you, which is a lot of times what I did. I kind of just was a magnet for people that were attracted to vulnerable, kind of insecure, neurotic, needy women. And there are certain type of guys that like those type of girls. Watch out, because they will give you the attention you want, but when they're done with you, you will feel like a piece of trash, basically. So, you know, that's something that I really had to simmer on and focus on. And as much as I still make mistakes with this, guys, because I'm not totally like changed and healed, I've accepted it, and I've really taken a hard look in the mirror at who I am and who I want to be. And I feel like even though the 6 months could be looked at as a failure in some ways, a lot of ways it's opened my eyes, and it's really just made me want to keep going on this journey. It's not just a 6 month journey. It's a lifetime journey. It's a 6 year journey. It's a 60 year journey. It's whatever journey you want. And we're constantly growing, evolving, changing. And if you're not evolving and changing, you need to take a look in the mirror and say, why am I not changing? Why am I not evolving? What is holding me back from pushing through the uncomfortable times in my life? And that's why I'm glad that I did this, because I finally got to the point where I'm okay being uncomfortable and pushing forward. My last tidbit, for as much as I could sit here and go through every little thing I did, every little thing I didn't do. I could talk to you about monotonous, tedious things that I've learned. I could, give you a spiel. I could lie to you for all you know. I could lie to you and say I did all this stuff that I didn't do because you guys don't know any better. But I'm not. I'm going to keep it 100% real, because I promised you I would do that. What I want to say to you and what I want to encourage you with is that, sometimes we look at the things that we haven't done in our life and we really get hard on ourselves, and we start to isolate ourselves, and we start to believe that we failed, and we start to believe that we're not good enough, and we start to believe that nobody's ever gonna love or accept us for who we are, so we don't love or accept for who we are. We start to think that if we didn't hit the bullseye that we failed and we should just give up. And that is complete bullshit, people. Bullshit. Okay? Yes, I curse. All right? You've changed one thing in your life. If you fixed one habit, if you've changed one pattern, my friends, you've succeeded. If you're afraid to fail, you will never succeed. If you're afraid to take a chance and miss the bullseye, don't even pick up, that hypothetical weapon. I'm not talking about actual weapons here, people. Calm down. Don't even shoot for anything. If you're scared to look like an idiot, if you're scared to look like a fool, then just sit in your house and watch Netflix all day, because taking risks is the risk of looking like a fool. Taking a risk is the risk of getting rejected. Yes, I am a hopeless romantic, people. I'm here to tell you that I would rather take a million chances than never know what it's like to experience real love. But that doesn't give me an excuse to act like an idiot, or to call myself a victim, or to continue to hurt myself with people that don't value me. Just because you are a hopeless romantic, or because you wear your heart on your sleeve, or because you're sensitive, doesn't mean that you just get to say, this is how I am, and then continue to make mistake after mistake after mistake, and then blame the person for doing it when you've only done it to yourself. Once you're self-aware, guys, you have no excuse but to change. Once you really get it, once you know who you are, and I like who I am. That's the thing. I learned to love who I am without using who I am as an excuse to not change or evolve or grow. And that is key. Accepting who you are, loving who you are, being easy in who you are, but don't use the who you are as an excuse to not grow and evolve and change, because it is bullcrap. And even though I didn't do everything I wanted to do in 6 months, I got real with a lot of things, and I'm continuing to on this path, because I know that I asked my daughter last night what she thinks I've changed in 6 months, what she feels like I changed the most, and she said my attitude. And guys, if your daughter, or if one person in your life says the only thing they've seen change in your life is your attitude, you have not failed. You have succeeded. So if you want to start a journey, or you want to start some kind of life change, and you feel like, I can't do it, I've already tried, I'm this, I'm that, trust me, guys, I fight my laziness and I fight my complacent spirit every single day of this entire existence. I fight my demons every day. I fight my procrastination. I fight all of the things that make me. I know I'm kind of a mess. I know I'm a free spirit. I know I'm a hopeless romantic. I know that I ramble. Okay, guys, I know all of this stuff about me, but I also know that we are all just works in progress. Whatever you're doing, whether it's one small thing, whether it's one big thing, if you're on the path to change and growing, you just keep going. You gotta fail big to succeed big. You gotta try hard to fail hard. And honestly, failure is not failing, because that means that you tried. You can't fail unless you tried. So continue to fail. Continue to mess up. Continue to make yourself look like an idiot. Continue to put yourself out there for someone who might love you. Learn how to guard, protect, and heal. Learn how to be smart. Learn how to be discerning. Learn how to look at warnings and red flags. But by golly, don't be afraid to take a chance. Don't be afraid to take a risk. And don't be afraid to live, because this is it, guys. We have this life to live with this flesh. What happens, afterwards is up to what you believe. But right now in this skin, we have one life. So just decide what you want to do with it. I encourage you to start your own journey. I still believe that this could be something bigger than it is. And I need your support. Let's stop tearing each other down. Let's stop being negative. Let's really just encourage each other in whatever we're doing, whether we you know, supported or not, let's just not be nasty to each other. Just build up the support and to just be kind to one another. And I'm gonna stop talking. I hope you guys had a great weekend, and I will be back next week with a new topic. God bless you.
I have to ask you a question. What do you think of your mommy?
But I don't know, but I can't wait to get her to be.
Slayer, what do you think has changed the most in 6 months?
Oh,
I feel like your attitude has changed.
I feel like I'm a more positive person.
Nick it.